Good morning, students. Today I am going to start chapter number 3, Money and Credit from Economics. And today's topics are, number 1 is money as a medium of exchange, number 2, modern forms of money, number 3, currency, and number 4, deposits with bank. So students, as you know very well that nowadays money is a very important part of our everyday life. If we will look around us, then we would easily be able to identify each and every transactions involving money in a single day. So students, as we know that in many of these transactions, goods are being bought and sold with the use of money. And also, in some of these transactions, services are being exchanged with money. Alright? So students, a person holding money can exchange it for any commodity or service that he or she might want. Okay? Thus, everyone prefers to receive payments in money and they exchange the money for things that they want. Both parties have to agree to sell and buy each other commodities. This is known as a double coincidence of wants. So students, first of all, we have to understand here that what is a double coincidence of wants. It means, students, what a person desires to sell is exactly what the other wishes to buy, is known as double coincidence of wants. For example, we can take the case of a shoe manufacturer. He wants to sell shoes in the market and buy wheat. And the shoe manufacturer will first exchange shoes that he has produced for money, and then exchange the money for wheat. So students, imagine how much more difficult it would be if the shoe manufacturer had to directly exchange shoes for wheat without the use of money. And he would have to look for a wheat growing farmer who not only wants to sell wheat but also wants to buy the shoes in exchange. That is, both parties have to agree to sell and buy each other commodities, is known as double coincidence of wants. All right? So students, after that, your next question is, what is barter system? So students, in a barter system where goods are directly exchanged without the use of money, and the double coincidence of wants is an essential feature of a barter system. Alright? And in contrast, in an economy where money is in use, money, by providing the crucial intermediate step, eliminates the need for double coincidence of wants. So students, we can say that money acts as an intermediate in the exchange process, and it is called a medium of exchange. All right. After that, your next topic is modern forms of money. So students, you know very well that we have seen that money is something that can act as a medium of exchange in transactions. And before the introduction of coins, a variety of objects was used as money, which you can see on page number 40. Like early punchmarked coin, maybe 2500 years old. After that, Gupta coins, Tughlaq coin, and gold mohar from Akbar's reign, and modern coins, etc. So students, as you know very well that before the introduction of modern form of money or currency, people used that kind of coins for the exchange of goods and services or for the buying and selling of goods and services. So, for example, since the very early ages, Indians used grains and cattle as a money. All right. After that, currency. So students, modern forms of money include currency, paper notes, and coins. And all these things that were used as money earlier, like modern currency is not made for precious metal such as gold, silver, and copper. And as I told you above that, earlier people use grain and cattle. They are neither of everyday use. And the modern currency is without any use of its own. Okay? Then, many questions will arise here that why is it accepted as a medium of exchange? Student, please try to understand here. I want to say that whatever coins made by the kings and sultans of India in the early ages of Indian history that were made by the precious metals like gold and silver, etc., etc. But nowadays, whatever we are using, that coins made by simple metal and also paper money is also made by the simple paper. So why it is accepted as a medium of exchange? So students, answer is, money is accepted as a medium of exchange because the currency is authorized by the government of the country. And in India, the Reserve Bank of India issues currency notes on behalf of the central government. And according to the Indian law, no other individual or organization is allowed to issue currency. And also, no individual in India can legally refuse a payment made in rupees. All right? That's why, students, the coins and rupees both are widely accepted as a medium of exchange in all over the India. After that, in this reference, again, your next topic is deposits with banks. So students, in this topic, we will discuss that the other form in which people hold money is as deposits with the bank. Okay? As you know all very well that People deposit money with the banks by the opening a bank account in their name. And banks accept the deposits and also pay an amount as interest on the deposits. All right? And people also have the provision to withdraw the money as and when they require. All right? Since the deposits in the accounts can be withdrawn on demand, and these deposits are called demand deposits. So students, I think you all are aware and know about the procedures of banking system and how you can deposit your money in the bank and how you can withdraw. So this topic is very easy for you. All right? After that, it is this facility which lends it is essential characteristics of money. And you would have heard of payments being made by checks instead of cash. You have to pay attention here. In my above explanation, I told you about the importance of paper notes and coins. And now I am going to discuss with you payment being made by checks instead of cash. So students, for payment by check, the buyer who has an account with the bank make out a check for a specific amount. All right? And a check is a paper. Again, one question will arise here, that what is check and why it is important and why check is also as a medium of exchange and accepted by everyone. So students, for payment by check, the buyer who has an account with the bank make out a check for a specific amount. And a check is the paper instructing the bank to pay a specific amount from the person's account to the person. So students, as I told you that a check is a paper instructing the bank to pay a specific amount from the person's account to the person in whose name the check has been issued. All right? And the facility of check against demand deposits makes it possible to directly settle payment without the use of cash. Understood? Since demand deposits are accepted widely as a means of payment along with currency, and they constitute money in the modern economy. But for the banks, there would be no demand and no payments by checks against these deposits. And the modern forms of money, currency and deposits are closely linked to the working of the modern banking system. All right? So students, this is the system and modern forms of money in which we can settle down payment and we can buy and sell things or goods and services with the help of coins, paper money, and also payments with the help of check we can do. All right. So students, for today's, that's all. Thank you and have a nice day.